Hey YouTube, 51 Bravo here. About to embark on my fourth knife build, and it really wasn't my intent to make knives out of other objects, but it's kind of leaning that direction, and I had a friend of mine, Mr. Brian Ballard, that was nice enough to donate a couple farriers rasps, which I will show you here in a minute. And I got to doing some research on that, and I think that's going to be my next build.
So here are the two rasps that he gave me. And so the first thing that everybody tells you is that you don't want to make things out of mystery metal. So this one is a Nicholson rasp. This one is a Save Edge rasp. And as you can see here, I have my little mini forge. And what I'm going to do next is anneal these so I can begin to work with them, because from the research that I've done and from a good buddy of mine, Greg Griffin, he tells me that these will both work just fine. He's done a bunch of them, so we're going to give it a shot. Okay, so I am going to anneal the Nicholson. And what annealing means is I'm going to go ahead and put it in my forge here. I've got my torch in there, in my fire brick, and I'm going to heat this up until it's cherry red, and then I'm going to test it on my little magnet here. And as you can see, it sticks to it right now, but once it becomes non-magnetic, then I can go ahead and dunk it in this sand, and it will cool slowly and will make this metal softer and much easier to work with. Okay, so as it turned out, my little baby kiln here can't handle this big old Mac Daddy farrier's rasp. So as you can see right about in the middle there, I got it non-magnetic to about there. So in other words, as deep as the kiln was, and I decided to try to, and I don't know if it's going to work, I'm going to anneal half at a time, because I really would like to try to make a big chopping knife. I haven't made a big camp knife yet, so I want to try to do that. But in the meantime, I think I'm going to take the other one and cut it in half and make two smaller knives.